Am I the asshole for telling a woman that she's the reason I left an after-school program? Up until a few months ago, I was the activities director of a before and after school program that also takes children in small pods for alternative school. I have my teaching license and degree and also a bachelor's degree in early childhood education, so I'm extremely qualified and trained for my position. And, since I was in the military for about 6 years to pay for my education, I thought I was pretty adept at being screamed at and demeaned by people for no reason. One of the kids I had in my study pod, Brandon, had really bad behavioral issues. It wasn't anything related to an actual disorder. Brandon, to be frank, is just a spoiled little shithead who has absolutely no parenting beyond an iPad and dismissive parents. It took about 4 weeks for me to realize that I couldn't stand him, and one of the biggest reasons was his mother. Brandon was awful, but his mother, Brenda, was worse. She's one of those parents who doesn't do anything to parent their children into decent humans, but rather she ignores her parental duties and then lashes out when her son is called on his behavior. We had weekly reports we submitted on each kid in our pod. I tried everything I knew how and took advice on how to help Brandon out of his behavior, and nothing worked. In fact, Brandon's behavior worsened, and it seemed he was taking pleasure in behaving abysmally. I tried to engage his mother to help with his behavior and quickly learned that she is a big part of the problem. She doesn't parent Brandon, she just leaves him to his electronic device. She's one of those parents who expects everyone else to parent her kid and lashes out when Brandon's behavior is called out. I must have had 7 or 8 nasty phone calls and personal meetings with her where she screamed, accused, threatened, bullies, called me nasty names. I eventually developed anxiety and depression, and through therapy realized that dealing with Brandon and his mom were a huge part of the problem. So, I quit the program at the end of term in May and got a job elsewhere. I recently ran into Brandon's mom at the grocery store, and she had audacity to come up to me acting like we were buddies, telling me she missed having me as Brandon's teacher. Brandon missed me. No one had cared about Brandon like me. Why did I leave, etc. So I told her point blank that she was the reason I left. That she had been an awful person, and the thought of dealing with her caused me real mental anguish and stress. Basically, I unloaded on this woman in public. I called her a bitch, a bad mother, an awful person. She started crying and left the store without completing her shopping. And, a couple of onlookers called me a bitch and a bully. Am I the asshole? Edit. Some folks were expressing concern that this would affect me in future employment with teaching. I've left the teaching field entirely and am currently employed in a field of study that I had a double minor in while gaining my bachelor's. My current job is remote and the company doesn't operate in my state, so I'm not worried about repercussions. Not the asshole. Publicly calling her out may be the only way anything will get through. Not the asshole. People reacted like that because they don't have the full context. But also awful people like Brenda love weaponizing tears when called out. Don't feel bad. You did nothing wrong. I won't give you a judgment. This was far from your finest moment. But it also sounds like it may have been cathartic for you. Maybe the mother learned something from this experience, that she can't just treat everyone like shit. Maybe you've been only going over bad interactions, which made her grow in your kind from an asshole to a villain. This is something for you to discuss with your therapist. I hope you can continue your healing process. Not the asshole. People shouldn't get a free pass for being a complete ass to others. You reap what you sow. If she didn't like being called out and being called foul names, she shouldn't have done that to you when you were in a position where you just had to take the abuse. Not the asshole. She sounds delusional, and you were nice enough to give her a dose of reality. Not the asshole. If this is how she is treating teachers, there is truly no mechanism to restrain parents that are like this and protect teachers. If you multiply the amount of abuse you endured over the time that you endured it and compare it to the 5 minutes she had to hear the truth, you are still owed time to yell at her before you're the asshole. You didn't do it in front of the entire parent group or teachers she still has to interact with. As long as your current job is secure, I think you are not the asshole. Not the asshole. She asked a question and got the answer. I must have had 7 or 8 nasty phone calls and personal meetings with her where she screamed, accused, threatened, bullies, called me nasty names. So she's upset you treated her the way she treated you? Not the asshole. Am I the asshole for helping my brother run away from his wedding? I have 2 older brothers. This is about the middle one. Our parents divorced when I was very young due to our mother's insane jealousy. At first, my dad was able to handle it, but when she started making comments about me wanting to be like his wife, he had enough. She quickly rebounded with a guy with two kids and had shared custody for a while. But when my dad got remarried, she went crazy, calling his new wife every horrible name and claiming he was cheating on her while they were married. I was always closer to my brothers and dad than my mom because she was always very mean to me. Long story short, my stepmom died in a bad car accident and my dad called her in the middle of the night letting her know he would pick us up earlier so we could attend the funeral, and she decided to take us on a fun trip to celebrate something. It was the happiest we've ever seen her, and when we realized what happened and started crying, she told us only worthless people cry for WHS. Needless to say, things went nuclear and my dad asked for full custody with visitation for her. He always left the line of communication open and paid for us to visit her when she moved away, but it was still very bad, and as soon as we turned 18 we started to lower contact with her. Last time we saw her was on my HS graduation, where she made a point of letting everyone who would hear we were ungrateful kids, and her HB would call us bad names too. Been NC since then. My brother Sam started dating his ex 3 years ago. She has heard all the stories and the reasons we are NC, but she believes we are just dramatic. They had many issues due to her opinions, but she eventually seemed to drop the "you need to reconcile with your mother" crusade. During the wedding planning, there was no indication of things going wrong or fishy. Then we got to the church and lo and behold, mom, HB and two kids were sitting at front. I immediately panicked and called my brothers. Sam thought maybe somehow she found out and wanted to crash, so he called his ex to let her know of the potential drama, but she told him it was fine since she invited them. Sam hung up and asked me to go get him while oldest brother dealt with things at the church. We went home and barricaded ourselves there even when his ex, her family, friends, etc. came to try and make sense with him. Mom's HB even called and said he always knew we were worthless. Now that the dust has settled, most of Sam's friends are on his side, and so is most of our family. Dad's ex's parents already threatened to sue for the money they paid if he doesn't marry her, but Sam says he rather pay them back for their contribution than marry someone that betrayed him. My nuclear family 100% supports Sam, but the backlash has been huge. Edit. You guys just reassured us all. Thank you. Some have commented about it, but no, she has not apologized. She even went so far as to text my oldest brother, Joe, that she thought it would be a good wedding present from my brother to her since she values family. My dad bought them a house as a wedding present, but only Sam is on the deed. She did have keys for when they moved there, but they just had the locks changed today, and Joe and some cousins are taking everything Sam owns from her flat during this week. We aren't worried about being sued, but we'll consult a lawyer just in case. We also heard mom and her family are still in town, but since we are all staying at our childhood home for a few days, we don't care. My dad is sad that Sam is heartbroken, but is trying to cheer him up along with my boyfriend and my sil. I had to deactivate my SM because I kept getting nasty comments and messages, but the more people learn the reason Sam run away, the less it gets. I am still sorry she felt humiliated, but my brother comes first. Edit 2. We are 34, 32, and 28. Exel is 30. Not in the US. I asked Joe about the church aftermath and it was just as I expected it. He says he stood up in front of everybody and told them Sam was not coming and to please go home, and all their gifts delivered to our side of the family will be given back ASAP. The ex was still outside the church when someone in her family informed her, and she started screaming and crying and calling Sam nonstop. Mom tried to talk to Joe that didn't even look at her, and when she couldn't get a reaction out of him, she started crying loudly and lamenting how horrible we are to her, and some people started consoling her. This is her M.O. But Joe and his wife didn't care. When they went out of the church, the ex was expecting them and demanding to see Sam, but Joe said no. Then she demanded to know what to do with the party, and he said if she didn't want the venue, he would arrange for the food to be donated to the staff there so it wouldn't go to waste. Everybody was screaming except Joe because he didn't want to give mom the satisfaction. They, Joe plus Sil, came home after stopping at the supermarket and some fast food joints, and we have been inside like we are kids again, plus two more members. We asked Sam if he wanted them to go, but he said he wanted them there. We had all taken time off to spend family time after the wedding anyway, so it's not a problem at the moment. When the ex came to the gate, we knew she was not going to use the venue, so my Sil called them with Sam's info, told them to take the food, and also sent them some tips for their trouble. It seems we will get back all the alcohol that my dad paid for, so we will have a very drunk end of the year. A couple of people messaged me asking why did our dad ever marry our mom, and the answer is he really loved her and believed she was the nicest person ever. Turns out she wasn't, but she knew nobody, except I guess her nasty husband, would marry her unless she pretended to be nice. He considered staying with her until we were adults, but she kept getting worse. She used to get very nice and he thought she was changing, and then she would change again. As per my exel, we have no doubt that she believes mom is a nice person that has ungrateful children, because she is extremely charming and for some people is funny to make fun of others as long as it's not directed at them, but it still doesn't excuse ex. The only person Sam gave an explanation was his boss, who was at the church, but he is very understanding and was pretty shocked of what mom put us through, since we are fairly adjusted happy people. Our dad said that it was a shock for all of us and we can stay home as long as we need. Sam is moving home for the time being. I showed my family the post and they are moved by your niceness, but Sam wants you all to know X wasn't showing any concerning behaviors and he truly believed she understood his upbringing. He agreed to talk to her and her parents today, but only if it's at our home and we are there to support him, so it's going to be an interesting visit. Not the asshole your brother escaped marrying someone who is controlling and would not listen and respect his feelings. She instead went behind his back to invite the one person who traumatized you all. She did this because she knew better. He is lucky to have escaped a life of that. As for paying for the wedding, the bride is the one that made the situation unworkable. Brother should not have to pay anything. Play stupid games, win stupid prizes. Not the asshole. And #X200B. He was right to cancel the wedding. His bride was an awe. Not the asshole. He needs to run from her. Also, her parents can't sue him for dumping her and running from the church, can they? You did the right thing and so did he. Not the asshole. Someone who doesn't respect when their partner says they're NC with someone for a reason and goes as far as ambushing a reconciliation is not someone who should be in a relationship. Your NSIL, not sister-in-law, showed her true colors. Thank goodness your brother realized before separation had legal ramifications. Your mother has also not changed. She shared her skewed narrative to her family and they bought it wholeheartedly. Not the asshole, and I applaud your support for your brother. One word of advice from a non-exert. Tell your brother to save his money. I don't think they have a claim in court for it. Not the asshole. I don't understand why so many people seem to think it's necessary for reconciliations. When a person says no because A, B, C, just leave it. In the future, they may decide they want to try, but it should be their choice, not by force, otherwise it tends to make the situation worse. I mean, I haven't talked to my sister in almost 9 years for various reasons. If someone tried something like this, I would feel just as betrayed, and when people try to say things, I just shut them down. Not the asshole. The fiancé, or ex, completely disregarded your brother's boundaries. This total lack of respect would be unforgivable to me. Not the asshole. And even if your brother winds up paying for the whole wedding that didn't happen, it's still less expensive than either the divorce or miserable life he was headed for. Am I the asshole for not giving my cousin my grandmother's house after she passed? I'm a 27-year-old male and my grandmother passed recently. In her will, she left me her 4-bedroom, 2-bath house. Now, before my grandmother passed, she was in danger of losing the house because of unpaid taxes. She asked various family members for help, but none did. I was in college at the time and I had a huge student refund. She asked me for $1,500 to settle the debt. She said thank you and we never talked about it again. I didn't want my granny to be homeless after all. That was about 8 years ago. Fast forward to today and I'm now the owner of a house in the heart of Atlanta. Prime real estate, if I do say so myself. I plan on moving in at the end of the month before doing some light cleaning and renovation. Enter my cousin and her kids. She is upset with me because I got the house. She said because I don't have any kids I should give her the house because I'm her eyes, I got the house for free. I thought she was crazy, but a lot of our family is on her side. Stating that it's hard out here for a single mother. They told me I can buy a house one day because I am a able-bodied young man. It will be harder for her because she has 2 kids. I'm like, she chose to have those kids and that isn't my problem. Everyone is calling me selfish and hell, maybe I am, but my grandmother wanted me to have the house. Am I the asshole? Not the asshole. Where was she when granny was about to be homeless? Not the asshole. It's your house. I hate the narrative that people who don't have kids should roll over to give people with kids anything and everything they want. Not the asshole. Your gran left you the house. It's yours. Your cousin has absolutely no right to it. Why should having kids make her more eligible for it than you? Don't even bother to engage in any further conversations with anyone about this. Not the asshole. Depending on where in Atlanta, property taxes can be an expletive redacted and struggle. If your cousin wasn't able to help your grandmother out in her time of need, what makes her think she'll be able to afford property taxes, utilities, and TC? Now, enjoy your new home, op. Not the asshole. If they want your cousin to live in a house so bad they can let her and her kids move in with them. Your grandmother left the house to you. If your family keeps harassing you, just tell them that you're respecting your grandmother's last wishes and leave it at that. I'd recommend that you change the locks on the house ASAP just in case any of them have a spare key to it. Not the asshole. So, outside perspective. Did your grandmother really need to back taxes money? Or, is it possible she reached out to family to see who among them would be willing to help without question? You were the only one who did so without hesitation or demands. You got the house. Seems Granny was testing the waters while deciding what to do with her personal affairs. Not the asshole. Her having kids does not entitle he to the house left to you. If your Nana had wanted her to have it, she would have given it to her. I am so sorry for your loss. Don't let anyone guilt you out of your inheritance. Nope, not the asshole. Grammy already knew exactly what was up. Where were your cousin and the rest of the family that is now on her side when Grammy was about to lose her house and you were the only one to step up then? Are they all disabled single moms who cannot help? If that family wants your cousin to get the help she needs, they should totally, 100% offer her their house for use for her and her kids. _... family. You should give your cousin your house. You. Let's see what Grammy has to say about that, pulls will out of pocket. Am I the asshole for calling out my girlfriend for living a double life? I, 23M, have been dating my girlfriend, Jane, 21F, for nearly a year. We go to separate colleges about 40 minutes away from one another, but we still see each other multiple times a week. I've noticed though that she always prefers to come to my apartment in a small town rather than me visiting her at her apartment. When we talk about family, she is always very reserved and just tells me that she's not close with hers. As far as friends go, I've met a great deal of her high school and college friends that all seem average. Now, she's always presented herself as a broke college student, and will actively say that fact whenever money comes up and laughs it off. However, I've noticed over the months that despite saying that, she refuses to eat fast food, she likes going on impromptu mini vacations, which by her standard are just staying within the country but are by no means cheap, and she drives a car worth over $70,000. Last night we met up with a few of her childhood friends to shoot pool. A few of them noticed that I drive a Tesla that I just bought for myself brand new this year. It's my pride and joy, and I will admit that I've done quite well for myself over time and building up my own income. Here's where the red flags start. They all called her by a different name. Rather than her name that I and all her friends have met before call her by, they were calling her something else completely. All of these friends were also foreign, coming from Brazil, Spain, Ivory Coast, and etc. Eventually, while talking about my car, a Brazilian girl named Camilla asked Jane if she intended to ask her father to buy her one. Jane just shrugged it off awkwardly with a, maybe. Throughout the night it became glaringly obvious that all of these childhood friends came from extremely wealthy families, so I asked Jane how she met them. She said that they went to school together overseas for a while and went to summer camps together. Jane also spoke to most of them in languages other than English, mostly French or Spanish as that's what they all seemed to know besides English. After we left back to my place, I asked her what the deal was, and she said that she does come from a well-off family, and the name that her friends called her was her actual name. She just went by a more common one when she came to our state because it was easier for people to pronounce. I felt miffed that she had been lying about her source of income for what seems like years, and that she actually had a lot more money than she had let on. I asked her if I could look at her Venmo, in which I see regular deposits from her father ranging from $400 to $1,000 weekly as an allowance. I called her a trust fund baby, and told her that she's a liar for pretending that she doesn't actually have money when she clearly does, and that she's just masquerading around lower classes and likes looking at how we all live. She got extremely upset with me and left, and is still refusing to speak to me. Am I the asshole? Masquerading around lower classes and seeing how we live? Are you serious? Dude, you're the red flag, double life here. On what planet can a lower class 23YO college student afford a brand new Tesla? Maybe this story is fake. Maybe you're just oblivious to what the lower classes means, but either way you are the asshole. You are the asshole X10. You've acted like a jealous, insecure jerk. She lives her life in the open. The $70,000 car, etc. And introduced you to her friends. She let you look at her Venmo, an act of transparency, and you used it against her. Your behavior is precisely why well-off people sometimes keep it quiet. You are the asshole. Maybe she should have told you, though I can see her not wanting to be judged or used for her family's wealth. You calling her trust fund baby and accusing her of just wanting to see how lower classes live, when you drive a Tesla at 23. You aren't lower class, dude, get off your high horse, was ridiculous. Maybe the fact that you are so judgy is why she isn't speaking to you. You are the asshole. I called her a trust fund baby. Gee, I couldn't possibly imagine why she kept that from you. You are the asshole. Her money is none of your business. You going through her Venmo is a disgusting invasion of privacy. Maybe she really likes you and didn't want you to feel uncomfortable because she has more money? There are guys that freak out over that. You are the asshole. Did you ever stop to think that maybe the reason she omitted the fact that she came from a wealthy family is because of the fact that she would be called a trust fund baby? Just because you come from wealth does not mean you have to flaunt it. Many people change their names for the same reasons she has given. Maybe she doesn't care about money, but quite obviously you do. Many wealthy people choose to live independently of their wealthy families, because they want to be independent and not live off of them. She didn't exactly lie. She may not have been forthcoming in flaunting it, but there was no lies told. Has she asked for you to regularly give her money or pay for things because she can't afford it? If not, you are the asshole.